Hello, I'm going to show you how to make a streamline or broad pen from Merbau.
These are the bits and pieces we'll need to make the pen. We've got an end cap, a mid band, ink refill, clip, two 7mm brass rods, a twist mechanism and a Merbau.
This is the specs on the Merbau. This is structural. I got it from Bunnings. It's about $16 for 8 foot of it, 2.4 meters. First thing we're gonna do is measure out about 20 mil. So we get 20 mil from there. It's about there. 20 mil. And we need about twice the length of that. With a little bit of extra. So I would say about there. We'll cut that there and down there. And 20 mil away. That's it marked out. Now to cut. So Merbau is a hardwood from Papua New Guinea. It's used in construction, it's used a lot in decking, things like that. But it's also a lovely orange wood and it makes a really nice pen when you're using gold trims. Now. That's our pen blank. Okay, we're going to take the pen blank and drill a 7mm hole right the way through the center. It's no easy thing to get it through the center, so I'm going to use the lathe rather than try and use a drill press or just a hand drill. It'd be next to impossible. This will ensure we get the hole right through the center of the wood, and we're using a 7mm drill bit. Turn it round. I'm going to turn it round, go in from the other side. Hopefully they line up. You never know your luck. What is in there? Oh, it's... Holy shit, there it is. It's quite a waxy wood. There's the hole. Straight through. Where's the camera lens? There you go. You don't know if you can see daylight right the way through. There you go. Okay, I've cut the blank in half. Two halves of the pen, one for each of the brass tubes. So now we've got to put the brass tubes inside there. I'll glue them in. First up, I've got to, yep, glue them. Gonna give the brass tubes a bit of a rough up so that the glue's got something to grab onto. I'm using 40 grit sandpaper. Just want to scratch the edge so the glue's got something to bite onto. It's not too smooth a surface, and the glue will bite into the wood. Using a cryo acrylate glue, which is also known as super glue. Also going to be using that for the finish on the pen as well, which is great fun. I'll get to that later. The two brass tubes, quite rough now, with a bit of sandpaper, ready for gluing. Next step. I'm going to be using a cyanoacrylate glue. It's super glue. It glues, it's known as CA glue. It glues in 1 to 3 seconds, so you can't dilly dally once you apply this. Get plenty on. I'm keeping it pointed down, and I've got a glove on my other hand so I don't end up with glue on my fingers. As it's going in, I'm going to twist to try and get good coverage, get it all the way in before it seals, just in past the tip. You see the other end there. And then what I do is put a bit of glue around that edge there, which is the first end that went in, just to ensure that we got a good seal on the wood at both ends. Doesn't matter that that's leaked out, as long as you don't touch it. And I'll do the same with the other one. Keep that angle down so it doesn't run back onto my finger. Spent a few hours biting this stuff off your skin. It's the only way you can get it off. Again, going in with a twist motion all the way in before it seals, just past the edge, and I'll do this end down here.
It's okay. You can stay down.
Okay.
You don't need to get up.
Okay, I'm going to take the chuck off. We don't need that anymore. I'm going to put a pen mandrel in. So that comes off, and in goes the pen mandrel, which is over here. There. Let's get that out of the way. We won't need drill chuck either, so that can go there. This is a little device called a mill, pen mill, and what we use it for is for taking the wood down to the edge of the brass tube. See, there's a little bit over, so we'll just need to get the wood down to the brass tube, and I'll use this pen mill to do that. I'm going to set that up now. Okay, with the glue now set, I've got a pen mill. It's a little mill. 7 mil insert, so that just fits nicely inside the brass tube. Grow in. Further. Now you can see the shine of the brass. That's what we're looking for. So I'm gonna do that on all four ends, two ends of two pieces. So again, this one should be easier. See the brass shining there. It's done. I do the big end first, so there's a deeper end and a near end. Shine of the brass, this shallower end, there's a bit of burn in there. Got the shine of the brass again. That's the milling done. We're ready to go on to the pen mandrel. Okay, I did mark the pen earlier, the wood earlier. And that's to keep the grain aligned. What I'll do now, because that mark's about to go, is I'm gonna put a similar mark here that I'll be able to see. I put a mark there and a mark there inside the brass tube. I'll be able to see that once the pen's been turned down, and that will ensure that I can align the grain as it was originally. I'm going to fit these bushes onto the pen mandrel. We've got three different size bushes. We've got an 8.9 mil, which is slightly bigger than the 8.4 mil. That's the 8.9 mil, and that goes on first. And that is going to be the clip end. Then we've got the center bushing, which is at 11 mil. That goes on the center. Then we've got the second part of the pen, and the last bushing is 8.4 mil, which is the right in tip end. With it all on and all aligned, the grain aligned, tighten that up, and I've got a pen mandrel which can come in. Just get that to tighten. Let's just see how she turns. Nice, no noise. Nice and tight. We're ready for turning the pen down to size. I'm going to use a gouge for getting the bulk of the pen down, and then I'm going to smooth it off with a square tip carbide just to save me a lot of sanding later on. I'll make a start. I'm going to run about 1500 RPM. going to go down to the square carbide tool. A bit smoother. A bit off this middle. Check the shape, it's a bit chubby here. A bit of a chub stuff. Pretty good. Yeah. Okay. That's okay. We'll move on to the sanding phase. Gonna sand now. Gonna use these sanding discs. I'm gonna go 120 grit, 180 grit, 240, 320, 400, and finish with a 600 grit. This is a bit where I just ensure we're right on the bushings to get the pen the exact right shape and size. Try and not get too much sandpaper on the bushings, because that'll change the size of them. Feels pretty good. A good tip is that when you're finished each grit, go with the grain of the wood, just to hide the scratches. Not sure what this angle's like. I'm probably in the way. Yeah, all you're getting is the back of my arm. Isn't that soft? Okay, it's not a good angle, is it? There you go. Anywho, 180. And again, just go with the grain of the wood. Can't see. Go with the grain of the wood. With the 180. Slightly. onto 240. Down the grain of the wood. A bit worried about this, and it's not getting a lot of love because I don't want to get my arm in the way of the camera. Moving on, 320. Hundred. Where have I gone? Done. Oh, 600. We're finished with a 600. Is finished. Next step, glue finish. For the glue finish, just going to use ordinary kitchen paper towel. Using four sheets. Going to do 20 coats of CA glue, super glue finish. There's a fold I do. I don't know if I can show you here. But yeah, well, I learned this from a guy on the Timber Bits website. So if you want to know how to fold it properly, go to the timberbits.com.au, have a look at how he applies the glue, because I'm just copying off him. Fold it in half, fold it to about half and half that way. don't know if you can see this, probably not. Camera angle's probably shitty, and then in half that way. Then all I'm gonna do is cut this, do six cuts into these with scissors. I'm gonna make 10 little finger-sized pieces of very thick paper so the glue doesn't come through and attach itself to me for the rest of the week. So I'll cut that off camera and come back. Okay, I've cut that into 10 little finger bits. I'm gonna lay them out there, two rows of five. 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I'm gonna use two applications per piece, which will be 20 coats of glue when we're finished. That feels nice and smooth right now. The other thing I'm gonna do is change these bushings over. I'm gonna change the bushings to nylon bushings because the super glue doesn't stick to the nylon, but it will stick to these. I'm gonna change them over. These are the nylon bushings that prevent the super glue sticking to the mandrel. So we pop that back on there. Last one there, tighten it up. Bit of a wobble there. I'm gonna go these are new gloves, never tried them before. They are recommended. But whenever I've done this, I end up with super glue. I put safety glasses on, so let's give it a go. Turn the speed down to about 800, or less than 800, so the glue doesn't fly off in my face. I'm actually gonna freehand. I don't know how I could do that with a glove on. So let's go. First coat. One, two, three. Smoothed all over. One, two, three. Smoothed all over. Nice and smooth. Nice and smooth. Done. Oh, it's stuck to me. I'm going to use my spray. I've got this instant glue that I use. A very gentle spray of this between each coat. And then using the same pad, I'll do a second coat. One, two, three. Spread all along, nice and smooth. One, two, spread all along, nice and smooth. Okay. Spread all along with a bit of a one, two, three. Spread it all along. One, two, three. Done. It's getting a bit tacky. That's four coats done. Coat five and six. fumes coming off it now. This must be 19. Is 20 coats of glue. A little bit on the finger, always get a bit on the finger. You see the orange on that now really starting to pop. I think you can see the orange on it really starting to pop. There we go, it's the pen. Next step, the glue is set. Gonna take the, go through all the grits, 1,500 through to 12,000 grit, very quickly. Probably stay a little bit longer on the first one, just make sure there's no lumps, but then quickly through all the grits. Gonna use wet water, okay, through the grits, up to 1,500 RPM. Starting with 1500 grit. I'll try and do it. It's a bit awkward doing it this way so you can see it. If you can see the white, that's layers of the glue. So the glue will be quite lumpy and uneven. This will bring it to a high polish. This process will not necessarily this grit. Just let it feel. A little bit there maybe. Thank you. 1500 grit. 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 Each one of these is putting a finer polish, applying a finer and finer polish. There's your 600 grit. Grit. One 6,000 grit, almost smooth. As you can see, it's still pulling some of that milky water off, so it's still shifting slight layers, smoothing out that glue, those glue layers. Grit. Feels really smooth now. And lastly, 12,000 grit. That's through all the grits. Just get a grit. Dry it off. Now that finish. That finishes. Pretty good. It's almost like plastic, a plastic finish. So next we'll apply Brasso. Stop. Last two coats to get a really sparkle and shine will be Brasso, and a car polish, cream, premium Caranuba wax polish. So we'll get rid of that water now, we don't need that. So, a bit of Brasso, apply it well, with the lathe off first, so you get a coating of it, and then we'll turn the lathe on to get a really good shine on that. You can smell the Brasso, a bit of heat there, not too much. You see it's kind of gone cloudy. This is my favorite part of the whole pen making process, which is the Brasso and the shine and the Brasso. Okay, count that spin. Now I hope you can see this. This is my favorite bit. So you take it off. I'll try and do it from the back so you can see it. You know, if you see the shine applying there. It's an amazing shine. Can you get on it? And that shine, it's really quite something. Now to protect that shine, we'll put a bit of Canuba wax on it. Same again, apply it while it's still, because it will fly off. And we do want to get a bit of heat on this to melt that wax and get the protection from it. So, let me get an application cloth. Now I'm feeling a bit of heat in there. That's what you want to be feeling now. You want heat to melt that wax. Friction heat. That's why I'm holding it like this, to apply pressure, applying quite a bit of pressure to get the heat, which will melt that wax in. That's it done. Now the last bit, just polish off that. Give that a minute. So really should see nothing coming off here. The cloth should stay clean. Have a little feel around, just make sure there's nothing in the bushings. There's a bit there came out, you can see. There's a bit of stuff in the bushings. You want to get right in there and get that out. There's a bit of wax in there. You want to get it all off. probably can't see anything because of the angle of my arm. But what are you going to do? And a polish. I don't know if you can see the shine or not, but it's quite amazing. This Merbau is a lovely orange wood that sits really well with gold. So now we'll put the, I'll take that off and we'll put the pen together. Last stage and we're done. Okay, assembly probably gonna get in the way. First thing you wanna do is put the tip on. Here's the, you probably can't see them against the wood. Here's the two finished parts of the pen. That's the writing tip, that's a clip end, center band sort of laid out. First thing we're gonna do is put the writing tip in, the pointy end, which is in there. So it's quite a tight fit. What we're gonna do is get that back to there. And just using this device, which is called a pen press, just to push that up nice and tight. As you can see, it's in, and the gold goes really well with the orange Merbau. Pop that there for now. Next thing is we get the twist mechanism, which is this. Twist mechanism's got a marking. Take it up to the mark, not all the way, because depending on how much of that brass tube we took out earlier on will depend exactly where the, so now we push this twist pen mechanism in, see the brass, see the mark, so we'll go up to about there. Now I'm going to put the writing bit in, and there's a twist mechanism, so I want it to twist. You see it comes out and I want it to go in. How far out it comes, that's actually pretty good, I think. We'll leave it at that. But to adjust, you just push it in a bit further. You can always push it in a bit further, not so easy to pull it out a little bit. So I'll leave it at that. Next thing is the clip end. So I get the cap and the clip, two separate pieces. That's the cap, this is the clip. The cap goes through the clip, and you may recall that mark I made earlier is going to align with that mark there. So that's the that mark, those, there's the two marks I made earlier in the brass tip. So this is the clip end. What I do is take a look, see if there's any nicer part of the wood than anywhere else, somewhere you might want to show off or somewhere you might want to hide. It's all pretty good. I don't think there's anywhere better than anywhere else, so I'll just go with what I've got. Just using the pen press, just push that in, tighten that up, push that in. Yep, yippers. And tight. That's the pen clip on. And the last thing is the ink cartridge is in. And this is the center band. So the center band goes on there. That's the wrong center band. That's the center band off a slimline. That's not a center band or a strain line. I got the wrong center band. Let me get another one. So we go there. That one on there. And there's the finished pen. It's pretty nice. The orange wood and the gold, I think, go really well together. pen retracted, pen extended, so it's twist action. The finished pen.